Hello everyone and welcome back to the second part of testing the TAN Scotch Brite pad. If you haven't seen the first part, I will put a link for it over here. You can check that out. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing, liking, sharing and hitting that bell button so you can so you don't miss another video. And I hope you find these videos interesting, at least as interesting as I find them. And today we're going to conclude the Scotch Brite series, that is until I find another part that I don't have access to right now. So today we're going to test the TAN Scotch Brite pad with a lot of pressure on the ball. Okay, so we're ready for the test. As always, there's not going to be any editing from now on. It's all going to be one take, scanning the ball, resurfacing, scanning again. Let's check the surface first so you can all see exactly what it is. Okay, that is around 5,000. And I'm gonna check another area. That's around 4,800. So it's pretty smooth, pretty evenly. I'm going to use our pad, which is again on the, this is going to be on the other side of the pad. So it has a completely fresh, unused surface. And we're going to hit it with a lot of pressure, just like the other videos. Exactly for 30 seconds for each side of the ball. Here we go. Okay, there's some material showing on here. I'm going to dust it off to do the other half. Okay, let me first show you what we've done. Okay. And another 30 seconds now. Okay, let's wipe it all off. Okay. Let's see what we got. This is a 3800 for these servers, for this area. And a 3300 for this area. So as an average, it's probably around 3500, maybe. Okay, so we got this ball from around 4900 to around 3500 average, and To be honest, I expected a lot more from this pad because it's supposed to be the heavy duty one, and I did use a lot of pressure. It does make a lot of lines on the ball, but it seems to be a lot of distance between them. So at some points the ball looks shiny but still has lines in them on it. I don't know, maybe this offers a different reaction on the lanes than having a 3500 ball that has no visible lines on it, but we can check that out on a different video on the lanes. That's it for the Scotch Brite series videos. I hope you liked it. I hope you have questions, or you have comments, or if you want to if you want me to try something else with the Scotch Brite pads, you feel free to comment below, and see you on one of the other videos. Thanks for watching. See you around.